38?
Present, ma'am.
39?
Present, ma'am.
40?
Present, ma'am.
41?
Yes, ma'am.
42?
Yes, ma'am.
43?
Present, ma'am.
44?
Yes, ma'am.
45?
Yes, ma'am.
So, roll number 28 and 34, both are absent today. So roll number 28 and 34, both are absent. Initially, it was showing the total participants 45. Now it is 44. I don't know what happened. And I'm logged in here once. Who is roll number 34?
Present, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what? Only 34 is present now. What is the name of 34?
Ma'am, Priyabrata Rajak.
Okay. Then Shubhadeep Maji, why you are answering?
Sorry, ma'am.
So only 28 absent today. 28 roll number. Last day I discussed, probably the note I have not given for diffraction 2.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I will send the note today. Given or not? Not given.
Not given, ma'am.
Okay, I will send the note today. I was very, very busy yesterday actually, so was not possible for me. So I will send this note and today's note, the previous note and today's note at the same time. So yesterday I discussed the diffraction pattern of double slit. Diffraction pattern of double slit. So for single slit also and double slit also, what you have to remember? The intensity distribution, the formula of intensity. You must remember the formula of total fill. E equal to what? That you will remember. Now the intensity distribution and for different principal maxima, minima and different secondary maxima, first order, second order, third order. So that you will remember, especially for double slit diffraction, missing order is very much important. Numerical problems are given for missing orders. And also what is the missing order? Explain like this. So the intensity distribution you will also must remember. And that intensity I0 is to I1 is to I2 is to I3, what will be? That is also very important. The ratio of these intensities in diffraction, single slit diffraction. And what is important here, starting of diffraction, that is what is the diffraction, what is the difference between Fraunhofer diffraction and Fresnel type diffraction. And also you will prepare the note here, that is what is the difference between grating and interference. So what is grating and interference? I will send the notes of the I will send it later, the difference. Or if you are getting it from any book, the difference between interference and diffraction. So two differences are important: the difference between interference and diffraction, and the difference between the Fraunhofer diffraction and Fresnel diffraction. So the single slit diffraction, what is the type of the diffraction? Fraunhofer or Fresnel type diffraction? Single slit diffraction. What is the type of the diffraction? Fraunhofer diffraction or Fresnel type diffraction?
Fresnel.
Huh? Fresnel. Who is answering? It proves that you don't know anything about diffraction. And you have not attended my class. You are present in my class but not attending. Single slit, double slit, this grating, that is the number of n slits. All are what? All are Fraunhofer type of diffraction. This light is coming from infinity. So this light is coming from infinity. So the source and this screen is situated as infinite distance. So these are all Fraunhofer type of diffraction. And in Fresnel diffraction, I told you all that two lenses are used. Two lenses are used in Fraunhofer diffraction. First lens is used to make the light coming from infinity. Source is at finite position, but after passing through the lens, this light is this is the type of the light, and it seems that this light is coming from infinity. So it seems, it is actually not true, but it seems that the source is at infinity. So the distance between the source and the screen is infinite. It seems here in Fraunhofer diffraction. And no such tool. And the second lens, this lens is used to focus this diffracted rays, because this screen is placed at focal point of the lens L. So another lens is here. It is not drawn here. Another lens, this type of convex lens is here. So from the source, if it is here, it is the source. So after passing through the lens, it comes as a parallel lens, and coming from infinity, it seems, and these rays are incident on this lens L after diffraction. So you are not listening, the students. How can you say this? This is from Fresnel diffraction. Fresnel diffraction, the source and screen, they are at finite diffraction, finite distance, and in Fraunhofer diffraction, source and screen, infinite distance. So from where it is coming? The rays are coming from infinity. And it is done by putting a convex lens in the path of the light coming from the point source. Now, if you have not understand, if anyone is not understanding single slit, he will not understand double slit. Also not understand this grating. Grating means n number of slits. You can see AB is one slit, CD is another slit, EF is another slit, GH is another slit. In this way, many number of slits. So all slits are not possible to show here. Only 1, 2, 3, 4 slits are shown here. But actually, the slit, that is the n number of slits. This is the grating, actually. And you have experiment in first year. This is the find out the wavelength of the laser light by the plane transmission grating. Right? That is the method of diffraction, laser diffraction. By the method of laser diffraction, by the method of diffraction using grating, you have to find out the wavelength of the laser light. So this same figure, only if the slit is AB and there are no slits other than AB, then it is single slit experiment. And in double slit, you observe that there were two slits AB and CD, and due to the combination, due to the superposition of the two intense two fields, due to that first slit, I calculated for double slit what will be the field here. And this point P, due to first slit and the second slit, and I took the sum of E1 and E2, and total field was calculated. And from there, what was calculated? Intensity distribution. Now here you can see n number of slits are there. n number of slits, and this is non-deviated ray, non-diffracted rays. These are, see, this is going just in this direction. So it is coming and it is going in the same way. So it is, so these lights are coming here, focused here at this point O. This is the principal maxima. And this diffracted rays, it is after focused by the this lens. This, these are coming, they are coming to this direction, where we are getting the, and on the screen we are getting the diffraction pattern. So it is n number of slits. A diffraction grating is an arrangement of large number of equidistant parallel slits. So these slits are equidistant, with separated by equal partitions. A plane transmission grating may be formed by ruling. So how it is important how a grating is formed? A plane transmission grating may be formed by ruling equidistant parallel lines with a fine diamond point on the optically plane glass plate. So if you want to build one grating, then what you have to do? You have to take plane glass plate, and on the plane glass plate, what is done? That is ruling equidistant parallel lines with a fine diamond point on the glass plate. The ruled lines are opaque to light, while the space in between two lines is transparent. So in between two lines, the place in between two lines, the different lines are drawn, many number of lines are drawn, and the ruled lines are opaque to light, while the space between the two lines is transparent. So the space between the two, that is transparent. Here A, B, C, D, E, F, G represents the section of a plane transmission grating. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G. You can see A, B, C, D, another slit. E, F, another slit. G, H, another slit. This is the plane transmission grating supposed perpendicular to the plane of the paper. Let the points A and C, C and E, C, A and C, this point from A to C. The points A and C, C and E, in the same way C and E, and E and G, then E to G. So A to C, A and C, C and E, E and G, in the same way you can write, separated by a distance D equal to A plus B. So this is equal to A plus, this is our D here, this is A plus B. So A and C, first I'm considering this point, A point and C point. This is what? This is D. The distance between these two, A and C, or C and E. So this is D, and what is this? This is A plus B, where A is the width of the opaque space and B is the width of the slit. So you can see AB. AB is the width of the slit, and BC, this is the opaque space, the width of the opaque space. This is the opaque space, the width of the opaque space is A, and B is the width of the slit. So you can see, so what is the distance, total distance AC? What is the total distance?
A plus B.
AC, AC.
A plus B.
A plus B. What is AB? Slit width. What is AB?
B.
B. And what is BC?
A.
This is A. So total AC equal to A plus B. And what is CE again?
A plus B, ma'am.
Okay. So C again A plus B. So this distance total, that is AC equal to AB plus BC. AB is the slit width, that is B, and BC is A. And this is the width of the opaque space. So you are drawing by, that is ruling equidistant parallel line on a plain glass plate. By which? By diamond point, by fine diamond point. So you are getting opaque space and you are getting transparent space. The ruled lines, that is opaque to light. This is the ruled line. Understand? This is the ruled line. This is the ruled line. This is the line actually that you are drawing. The ruled line, that means that is, this is, it is with this, that is, this is not for figure, it is shown here. That is, but what is this? BC is only the line, that the scratch you are doing on the glass, plain glass plates. A single scratch you are doing, you are drawing. So BC is that scratch. So it, this is opaque to light. Light can't pass through this. And another line. So this is first line, this is second line, this is third line, this is fourth line. In this way you are drawing. So what we are drawing, say these are the lines, different lines. I'm just drawing by a fine diamond point on a plain glass. Okay, say this is the plain glass plate, plain glass. And what we are doing, we are just drawing by diamond, fine diamond point, these lines. So actually, this is this line. So what is the width of this line? What is the width of this line? Say. What is? I said to. What is the width of the line? What is this? Say anyone.
A.
This is A. And what is the space between these two lines? What is this? B. Okay. So this is again B. So this is B. So this is the slit width. This is the slit width. This is, if I give name here, A, B, C, D, E, F. If I write, then AB is the one slit. Slit width. Okay. But here, in that figure, that it was shown some width of this line here, but I have drawn by single hand, so I can't. But actually, the line is showing like this. It say this is the slit width. It like this. This is the line. Say this is the line. It is in this way. Then again, this is the line. In this way. So in between these two lines, it is B. And what is this width? This width is A. This width is A. Actually, here it is shown that is line width. A single line is drawn, but actually here, this is like this, and this is A, and this is the slit width, B. This is the opaque space. These are two at the opaque space, and this in between, it is transparent space. So this is the transparent space by which light passes. Now come here. So this space, this is AB, BC, BCD, they are the lines that are drawn. So width, it is in zoom mode, it is shown. This is the line width. And this is the opaque space. BCD line can't pass through this region. Only light passes in between this space. This is the slit width. So the points separated by D are called the pair of corresponding points. The points separated by distance D. So what are the corresponding points? Say here, the points separated by distance D. Say, first set of corresponding points.
AC.
Then the second corresponding points.
C.
Then EF. EG, like this, separated by distance D. You can see, I'm putting in zoom mode. You can see it. So light is passing. So this is grating actually. So the question is given, what is grating? So grating is a plain glass plate on which by diamond, fine diamond point, lines are drawn. And that is an opaque space and transparent space is created the space on the line, this is opaque, and the space between the two lines, this is transparent, and this transparent space, it behaves as slit. In a plane wavefront, monochromatic light of wavelength incident normally on the surface of the grating. The diffracted light would consist a large number of secondary wavelets issuing from the clear space of the grating. From the different points of the incident wavefront, large number of rays are diffracted in different directions. So you can see the large number of rays are diffracted. This is the bending of light. Diffraction is the bending of light. So light is bended here at an angle theta. From the different points on the incident wavefront, large number of rays are diffracted in different directions. The lens L focuses the diffracted rays at an angle of diffraction theta at P. So it focuses, this is the length is used for focusing these diffracted rays on the screen P, on the screen. So now we are going to calculate the intensity distribution. So I'm directly coming to the intensity distribution. So same procedure, it is given. So for A1, field will be created at P. So for actually see here, not for every point it will be created. Now I'm coming for a single slit. Here I'm first considering the slit AB. I'm considering the slit AB. What is the field due to this slit on P? What is that was discussed in first? I say this is single slit and no other slit is there. Only AB slit is there. Now due to AB slit, what will be the field intensity here? Say, due to that AB slit, what will be the field intensity at P? Think about double slit. Think about double slit. We calculated E1 plus E2. E1 was the intensity. Intensity due to the first slit. Intensity due to the first slit. That was E1. Sorry, not intensity. Field due to the first slit. Dekho, idhar bahut sara slits hai. Har ek slits ke liye field hoga P par. P par create hoga har ek slits ke liye field. To uska sum calculate hoga idhar P pe jo hoga total field due to the all slits. तो एक स्लिट हो एबी स्लिट हो तो उसके लिए देख रहे हो तो बोलो ड्यू टू एबी स्लिट व्हाट बोलो ड्यू टू दैट एबी स्लिट व्हाट इज द फील्ड एट पी So this is the field. This is the field due to which? Due to the first slit AB. So I proved it in when I was discussing single slit. Single slit ho, to single slit ke liye, ek slit ke liye kitna hoga field? That is E1. And E2 is what? E2 is the field due to which slit? It is the field due to which slit on P? Say name is given, second slit. Say the name of the slit.
E2.
E2 is the field due to which slit? The on the
paper
BC. And BC slit. This.
CD.
CD. Black is. On the paper, if you draw on the paper one line by your pen, you say you are drawing two lines on the paper. You have pen and paper, you are drawing two lines on the paper. So that line that you are drawing, that is BC, that is DE, that is FG, that line, single line that you are drawing. And if you are drawing two lines on the paper, two lines parallelly you are drawing. Parallelly you are drawing two lines. So the space between the two lines, that is the slit. So what is the first slit here? What is the name of the first slit in this figure?
AB.
What is the name of the first slit in this figure? And what is the name of the second slit in this figure?
CD.
What is the third slit?
EF.
And what is the fourth slit?
GH.
Okay, so these are the slits. Now for all these slits, field will be created. In single slit experiment, only there was only one sheet. What was the sheet? AB. And no other sheet was there. Slit was there. So only the slit was AB. And the intensity distribution due to AB slit on P, what is this? This is E1. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
You forgot, all of you forgot everything. If you forget diffraction for single slit, then leave diffraction. You will understand nothing. What is this? E equal to what is this? A sine beta by beta sine omega t plus beta. What is this E? This is the single slit. Say, this is the single slit. This is the single slit. Only the slit. Only one slit is there. From this point to this point. And due to this slit, the field at P. What is the expression? The expression was, I told you all to remember this field expression. Otherwise, you will not understand. This is E. This is the field, A sine beta by beta sine omega t plus beta. This is the field due to one slit. So this is single slit on the screen. And this is the intensity that I was saying. There's, if only one slit is there, if there is only one slit. So you can see, this is only one slit. So the field intensity at P, what is this? The field intensity at P, it is given as this. A sine beta by beta sine omega t plus beta. Now I'm coming here. I don't know why you don't understand, you all. So if only one slit, what is the intensity distribution for AB slit at P? What is E1? Ek slit ho, sirf, I'm just show kiye, ki AB ek slit hai, uske liye diffraction ka jo hai, uska jo intensity, सॉरी फील्ड है पी पे वो क्या होगा ये ए साइन बीटा बाय बीटा साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस बीटा अभी देखो सेकंड स्लिट कंसीडर कर रहे दूसरा स्लिट है सीडी तो इसमें तो पाथ डिफरेंस होगा दोनों के बीच में तो ये डिफरेंट होगा फेस डिफरेंस भी आएगा वो था 5-1 ये हम डिस्कस किए डबल स्लिट में सब कुछ तो सीडी स्लिट के लिए फील्ड क्या है पी में ड्यू टू सीडी स्लिट व्हाट इज द फील्ड एट पी बोलो कोई तो बोलो नहीं तो हम प्रोसीड नहीं करेंगे
मैम E3
E3
मैम ए साइन बीटा बीटा
दिस इज फर्स्ट स्लिट दिस इज सेकंड स्लिट तो वी डोंट नो द कांसेप्ट दैट E1 मींस फर्स्ट सेकंड मींस टू सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट ड्यू टू एबी स्लिट दिस इज द फील्ड एट पी ड्यू टू द सेकंड स्लिट बीसी इज नॉट द स्लिट आई थिंक दैट यू हैव कंसीडर्ड दिस वन आल्सो एज अ स्लिट बीसी बट बीसी इज नॉट द स्लिट So second slit is your CD, transparent space. So what is the field due to CD? What is E2. The E2. So it is written here. If I write E3, then what I will write? Say, so similarities, check the similarity between the similarity and dissimilarity between these two. First one is beta, omega t plus beta, but second one is, first thing is same, and here minus 5-1. So phase difference is there. Phase difference is there, 5-1. Then what will be similarly, what we can write? E3? E3 is for what? E3 is the field due to which slit?
EF.
So E3 is the field due to EF slit. So here, what will be the expression of E3? It is not written here. Take the similarity and say, what will be here? E3 equal to what?
A sine beta by beta into sine omega t minus 2 phi 1.
Omega t plus beta कौन बोलेगा? We'll say beta. E2 equal to E3 equal to A sine beta by beta sine omega t plus beta minus 2 phi 1. So omega t plus beta. Just a minute.
ओटीपी लागबे
स्टूडेंट्स जस्ट वेट अ मिनट Am I audible, students?
Yes, students, ma'am.
Am I audible? Audible, to?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, what is the expression of field due to the field due to the slit EF? That is the third slit on this point P. What is the expression? Tell me again. E3 equal to what?
A sine beta by beta.
Then?
Ma'am, all things so remain constant, but 2, 5, 1.
Say, I don't want to say anything, know anything. That tell me the total expression. E3 equal sine, to what?
A sine beta by beta.
A sine beta by beta. Sine omega d plus beta minus 2, pi 1.
Okay. So, the field, this is E3. So you can say, see, the for the second one, here it is 2, but here it is 1. But if I write E3, so if I write E3, what I will write here? Minus 2, 5, 1, is it? If I write E3, it is 2, 5, 1, 2 here. It is 3 here, then again here, 2 for E3. And it is for E2, 2 is here and 1 is here. So in the same way, if I write EN, if I write EN, so what is the change? If it is capital N here, then what I will write in this space?
N minus
1. So this is the field due to the N slit, NH slit. In this way, only 4 slits are shown here, AB, CD, EF, and GH. But in grating, N number of lines are drawn. So due to that NH line, what will be the field at P? This is the. Now beta has expression this. Remember this expression of beta. Beta equal to what? Pi b sine theta by lambda. Remember this one always. And phi 1 equal to what? Phi 1 is the phase difference. What is this? This is 2 pi by lambda into path difference. So path difference is d sine theta. So phi 1 equal to 2 pi by lambda d sine theta. Now what is the resultant field at P? This is the sum of all these fields. And this is the sum of all these fields due to the n number of slits. A for sanitize.
Sanitize.
Packet ta. O to dhori shuna rekhe re amar hoye jakta.
Bolch to shunchhi na.
In on ache.
Ki on ache?
Class nichhi to.
Audio on ache.
So E equal to what? E1 plus E2 plus E3 up to EN. So this is the sum of all the fields due to the N number of slits. So just the mathematical calculation next. So this is the first one, E equal to what? A sine beta by beta. This is the common part. Then sine of omega t plus beta. This is the first slit due to the term. This is the due to the first slit. Term due to the first slit. This is the term due to the second slit. In the what will be the third term here? Sine of
omega. Sine omega t plus beta minus 251.
Okay, minus 251. Then the next term will be sine omega t plus beta minus
251.
So in this way, and this is the nth term. Now we can write mathematically. We can write this sum. So no need to show here. How show the process here. Only you will write the sum. So we can write this sum as a sine beta by beta. This is the common term. And if I write the sum of all this this bracketed term under the third bracket, inside the third bracket, then that is sine n gamma by gamma sine of omega t plus beta minus n minus 1 into phi 1 by 2. So this is the expression of the field. So this is the expression of the total field at P. Now where what I have written gamma, I have taken that pi d sine theta by lambda. And what is pi d sine theta by lambda? So d equal to what here? D equal to what?
A plus b.
So gamma equal to what? Pi into a plus b into sine theta by lambda. So this is the expression of gamma. So from here, what will be the, so you have the intensity, you have the field value E equal to this. So what is the intensity? You just square the first term. Okay. So square the first term. So what will be the intensity at P? Say, A square, square this term. A square,
square beta
by
beta square
into what?
Into sine square n gamma by
sine
square gamma.
Okay, so this is the intensity distribution for the grating. That is n number of slits there. So remember this one. It may be given. If you have, I don't know what will be the type of the exam. Actually, what I have not discussed for every slit. I have already discussed the for single slit. I have already discussed the double slit. And in double slit, only E1 and E2 was there. And we took the sum of E1 plus E2. Understand? So there only E1 plus E2 was there. And you know the intensity distribution of double slit. Now here, there are n number of slits. So E1, E2, E3, in this way up to EN, we are taking the sum. And here after taking the sum, this is the intensity distribution. This is very important from here. So this is the intensity distribution of n number of slits. And I am writing in two terms, I1 and I2. What is I1? I0 sine square beta by beta square. What is this term? I1 equal to I0 sine square beta by beta square. This is very, this term you know. This is the intensity distribution due to single slit. Remember or forgot?
Remember, ma'am.
Okay. So I1 is the intensity distribution due to single slit. So this is, and I2 equal to what? Sine square n gamma by sine square gamma. This represents the interference pattern due to the n number of slits. So this is the single slit, intensity distribution due to single slit, and this is the intensity due to the interference pattern due to the n number of slits. So due to the n number of slits, interference is taken place, and here, the total intensity due to the n number of slits, the interference pattern, this is represented by this. This is the pattern. This is the intensity of the interference pattern. This is the intensity of the diffraction pattern of a single slit. And this is the interference pattern, represents the interference pattern due to the n number of slits. Now again, three graphs are drawn here. So, this term, actually I equal to what? I equal to, it was I equal to I1 into I1 and I2. This is the sum I told you. So this is I equal to what? I1 and I2, the sum of this. I1 into I2 is here. So contribution of I1 and also the contribution for I2. Now here, so what is this? This is the total intensity due to n number of slits. Now it is divided in two portions, this into this. This is I1. This graph is for I1 and this graph is for I2. This graph is for I2. This is sine square n gamma by sine square gamma. This is I2. See here, you can see this graph. So actually sine square n gamma, sine square n gamma. You can see the first thing, sine square n gamma versus gamma. n gamma. This is the graph. Okay. Then sine square gamma and gamma here. Three graphs are combined here. Sine square gamma and gamma. It is plotted like this. Now the total term, total distribution like this. That is sine square n gamma by sine square gamma. So this is the, if we plot, so sine square gamma is plotted here. Sine square n gamma is plotted here. And now we are plotting here sine square n gamma by sine square gamma. It will be like this. And this is the term that is this is the diffraction pattern. And this term is the diffraction pattern due to the single slit. You know, these are the minima points, pi, 2 pi, here minus pi, minus 2 pi, in this way minus 3 pi. Here, say from the, I want to check, you remember or don't remember? 3 pi by 2. Beta equal to 3 pi by 2. What is the position? So I want to again say that in single slit diffraction, I took the conditions. First is principal maxima. What is principal maxima here in this? What is the intensity of principal maxima here? It is showing. What is the intensity of principal maxima for single slit? It is showing here.
I naught.
So this is the intensity of the principal maxima. Now what is the these points? Pi, 2 pi. What are these points?
Minima.
Also minus pi, minus 2 pi, minus 3 pi, these are minima. And what are these peaks?
Secondary.
So this is the principal maxima. This is secondary maxima. This is again secondary maxima. But the intensity will what? Increase or decrease? Towards this direction?
Decrease.
Okay. So that is beta equal to 3 pi by 2. What is the name? Secondary maxima? First secondary maxima. Okay. Beta equal to 5 pi by 2. It is second secondary maxima. You can see here actually it is shown. If I draw the perpendicular from here to here, we are getting this point. See, we are getting this point. Is it peak position? No, this is actually not the peak position. If I draw the line here, I'm getting here. Actually, this is not the peak. Peak is here. Understand? I discussed this problem last day. Actually, the peak is here. But we are taking, it is 3 pi by 2 here. And we are saying this is the first secondary maxima. Why?
For easier calculation.
It was beta equal to what? 1.43 pi like that it was. Actually, the two graphs, from that graph, y equal to tan beta and y equal to beta, the point of intersection of the two lines, that is the point of beta. And it was different from 3 pi by 2. So this is the actual position. But for easier calculation, it is 3 pi by 2. We have taken it 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2. So you can see the shift. Slight shift is there. Actually, the peak is here. Actual peak. But we are considering here for our so that we can easily remember. So this is the diffraction due to the first single slit, and this is the total intensity distribution of grating. This is the total intensity distribution. This is plotted. I equal to I zero sin squared beta. This term, this is the diffraction term, and this is due to the interference term. Now maxima and minima, different things are here. I equal to what? I zero sin squared beta by beta square, sin square n gamma by sin square gamma. This is the total. And I1 equal to this, I2 equal to this, you know. Now, condition of principal maxima. The condition of principal maxima, what? Where gamma tends to m dash pi. So, if you take gamma tends to m dash pi, sine n gamma by sine gamma equal to, mathematically we can write plus minus n. Where m dash equal to 1 to 3, therefore, when gamma tends to m dash pi, I2 equal to what? Gamma tends to m dash pi, I2 equal to n square. So here, I2, this is the term. Actually, I is the term I1 into I2. I1 is what? I0 sine square beta by beta square. And what is I2? Sine square n gamma by sine square gamma. Okay. So if gamma tends to m dash pi and m dash equal to what? 1, 2, 3 like this. Then what is this term? What is this term? Limit gamma tends to m dash pi sine n gamma by sine gamma. This is plus minus n. So this is plus minus n. So square is here. So sine n gamma by sine gamma. Limit gamma tends to m dash pi. So this is n. Actually, if we leave the square, then this is n. But here we have square term. So I will write what? I2 equal to capital N square. And as gamma tends to m dash pi, so pi d sine theta by lambda equal to m dash pi. So from here we can write d sine theta equal to m dash pi, where d equal to a plus b. So a plus b sine theta equal to m dash pi. This is the condition of maxima. So remember this one, the condition of maxima. So now I am not discussing much here because time is almost over. Time is over and it is 10:55. So only two things are remaining here. What are the two things? I will give the note if it is possible for you. Read it. Two notes I will share. Second diffraction second and diffraction third. So up to this I have discussed the total intensity distribution. And you just go through it. The next one, maxima and minima, in the same way for grating also. So maxima and minima, and here the next, the resolving power of grating. This is important, very important, very very important. Resolving power of end grating, and remember this one. This formula is very important. This from here numerical problems are given. I will give the numerical problems, then you will understand why I am saying it. These are the numerical problems. This is. Different numerical problems are given. So I will give it and you will prepare. Hey, this is the resolving power. So same thing is given. Lambda by d lambda equal to mn. Remember this formula and then calculate for resolving power of grating. The numerical is very, very important, I'm saying, from resolving power. So what is resolving power? Deduction is there. And from the intensity distribution maxima and minima is here. I'm sharing the notes, so you will read it, and if any problem arises, then we will discuss on the next day. Okay, so leaving the class.